Human papillomavirus infection is the most significant risk factor for cervical cancer. Persistent infection with certain high-risk strains of HPV, particularly HPV type 16 and 18, can lead to the development of cervical cancer. HPV is a common sexually transmitted infection, and many sexually active individuals will contract it at some point in their lives. However, the risk increases when the infection persists over time. Engaging in sexual activity at a young age has been identified as a potential risk factor for cervical cancer. Early initiation of sexual activity may increase exposure to human papillomavirus, a leading cause of cervical cancer. The immature cervix in young individuals might be more susceptible to HPV infection, highlighting the importance of comprehensive sexual education and preventive measures. Having multiple sexual partners is a well-established risk factor for cervical cancer. Increased exposure to different strains of HPV elevates the likelihood of persistent infections, making it more challenging for the immune system to eliminate the virus effectively. Cigarette smoking has been identified as a significant risk factor for cervical cancer. Byproducts of cigarette smoke concentrate in cervical mucus, creating an environment conducive to HPV infection. Moreover, smoking has been associated with a depletion of Langerhans cells, which play a crucial role in cell-mediated immunity. A compromised immune response increases the difficulty of clearing HPV infections and may contribute to the progression of cervical lesions. Engaging in sexual relations with individuals who have a history of precancerous or cancerous conditions of the cervix or penis poses an increased risk for cervical cancer. This is primarily due to the potential transmission of high-risk HPV strains from infected partners, leading to persistent infections and the development of cervical abnormalities. Immunosuppression, whether induced by HIV infection or medications used for organ transplantation, is a significant risk factor for cervical cancer. A weakened immune system is less effective in controlling HPV infections, allowing for prolonged viral persistence and an elevated risk of cervical dysplasia progressing to cancer. Women exposed to diethylstilbestrol in utero face an increased risk of developing clear cell adenocarcinoma of the cervix later in life. Diethylstilbestrol, a synthetic estrogen, was prescribed to pregnant women in the mid-20th century. The exposure is linked to structural abnormalities in the cervix and an augmented susceptibility to carcinogenic transformations. Some studies suggest a slightly increased risk of cervical cancer in women who have used birth control pills for an extended period. However, the risk appears to decline after discontinuation of the contraceptive. However, amidst these challenges, it is important to note that cervical cancer stands as one of the most preventable gynecologic cancers, primarily due to Pap test. The Pap test, or Pap smear, is a cornerstone in the early detection of cervical abnormalities and plays a pivotal role in preventing the progression of these abnormalities to invasive cancer. Understanding these risk factors is essential for promoting awareness, implementing preventive measures, and advocating for regular screenings can contribute to reducing the incidence of cervical cancer and improving overall reproductive health. If you found this information valuable, don't forget to hit the like button and share it with those who may benefit. Subscribe to our channel for more helpful content on health-related topics.